So if somebody asked you, who is DDS? Can you just tell me briefly, how do you summarize DDS?
Energy.
You will get fucked up.
Exactly. That's what I be trying to tell niggas.
Make it right.
Instead of coming and smoke Swiss with white players.
Yeah. Was Mr. Mind for a minute, eyes squinting. White trying to turn me to the car, wind slow, TV in.
Free speech, free spirited.
What's the definition of free speech? These streets, Rico PP, the beat vice lord, CD, Hat Kings, Black Queens, niggas wanna bury me 6 feet.
Rebel of society, and not in the sense of rebel of without a cause, a rebel with a cause.
Man, the preacher wanna charge me for sanity, cause I displayed what I was going through a little mentally. Hey, fuck him, but I got to love him. The strap is tempting to catch up with these fake folks and empty squeeze.
I feel like everything I do is a cause behind it. I just wanna rock the world in a way that's, unpredictably rocked, if that makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah. C4J Records, baby. Mealtown. It's a Mealtown thing, sweetheart.
Yeah, hip hop. Show.
Let them know.
Yes, hey, let the cats know who he is, bruh.
I be the roughest, toughest brother on your block. What? Tell your girlfriend about me. Yeah. Yo, tell your pop.
So, what were your influences coming up? I mean, how did you get started?
Well, in music. I was raised in a household where my dad and mom was not no musicians. They didn't play records. They never had any of that stuff. So a lot of music came from me going to church and hearing, the organ player. Or seeing people doing it, watching the box is really how I got in tune with like hip hop, or going over to my aunt's house hearing Marvin Gaye. While they partying, smoking their cigarettes, drinking whatever.
We kicking beats, rhymes, and life. We kicking beats, rhymes, and life. We kicking beats, rhymes, and life. We kicking,
drink whatever. I got to hear those kind of records, and that hit me on to music, instantly. I was like, dang, my dad, he did eventually put us all into music lessons. I took drums, one of my brothers took piano, one of my other brothers took guitar, and they never did nothing with it. So I used to just dabble on here and there with the piano.
A G, a gangster. Yes. Street talk for a tough guy has died.
Currency and double, Storax, not from the hustle. Mouth and muzzle, spew out lava, swing with knuckles. Riding in the driver's seat, 100 miles per hour. G, no seat buckle, blood bubbles, deep cover.
How do you digest the world of music today? So do you have any artists that you enjoy? Any genres that you enjoy?
My favorite genre is jazz because it's peaceful. A lot of people hate the fact that I love Kenny G. That's my favorite. One of my favorites, Kenny G. They say, well, that's not jazz, it's smooth jazz. Whatever, I've heard, I've done my research and, I love jazz because it's peaceful. Music today is, when we talking about the machine music versus the, music that people want to put out, machine music is what the radios play over and over from, the corporate sponsors that run from the top to the bottom. So if there's a station under, a certain corporation, they're going to play that kind of stuff for those artists to get it.
Yeah, pockets empty, silently sipping, the robbery's tempting, bank accounts minus 50, classified not your average guy, on the block lines, had to be fly, gangstify, yo, hat cocked to the rock.
Music, musicians, they just love to do music. I mean, we just jam out, we rock out, we go just, rock the world, in a sense that we just get into our own zone.
Hey, yo, I miss you, homie. They say you went away to school, but me and you both know, we both know the truth. You was a young dude, always acting like a fool, walking with your straight ace, trying to push a tool. I reminisce when we was in the back of the church and used to whisper at the little ladies with the shorts.
Like Bob Marley did, different artists like that, who just zoned out and just did what they wanted to do.
The shot show at the fire hydrant. You got the cops and they acting like friends. It's a shame my homie just got pinched. Now he in. But 25 life, I see my brother a kite. Tell him it's gonna be alright. But do you trust your wife? And just wanna know how it goes when it snows.
And in a sense, it's rebellious because you go against what's the norm. Our norm is. So music is doing what it's doing. Sales decline in a sense of the physical CDs being bought in some genres, you know. Rock and roll people support, you know, country artists, they support hip hop, which is the, you know, genre that I'm in. I love hip hop. I feel like it's just so many, it's oversaturated with so many artists that are alike. And I'm gonna hit with the wordplay. Hey, hey, yo,
I'm here with the wordplay. Okay, I first really realized Derek's potential after he called me up on a number of occasions. He started talking to me about music and rap music and gospel rap music and how he was going to change the face of the music industry. And I realized that he was this very intelligent, enterprising young man. I told him that he reminded me of a young Jay-Z, and he does. He really does. And so I've been kind of following his career, so to speak, and been interested in seeing how he develops and what he has in store for the world. And I know he will have an impact on the world.
I got my eyes to the sky, knees to the floor. Ain't nobody ever gonna do this no more. Man, explore the neighborhoods where I grew up, where everybody call you a screw up. I had enough at 12 years old, I decided I was gonna be a man. I got skeptical and grabbed my own plan. You gotta watch out for brothers that drive without a license. They'll come through busting shots, yo, at the fire hydrant. You got the cops and they acting like friends. It's a shame my homie just got pinched, now he in. For 25 life, I send my brother a kite, tell him it's gonna be alright, but do you trust the right?
Let's see, Derek, you just gotta have to laugh because, you know, like, dude is just crazy, like, he's a fucking dude. But, let me see, I remember when I met him, right? Well, it was real because I didn't really meet him. I remember the first time I ever came to Columbia, he was, like, at the spoken word or something like that and performed, like, 20 times in one night. But that was good, like, that was decent. So after the show, I told him he had done a good job or whatever. I'm
a king. Diaz. Well, I had the pleasure of meeting this brother at a spoken word, and it was cool. We just collabed on one tune. I played saxophone, by the way, and he was beatboxing and he was rapping, and I thought everything that he had to say was pretty much relevant to what's happening, you know, things going on today, being a youth of this environment. But with that said, I think this is going to be a bad cat. He's creative and he thinks outside the box.
There's artists out there who are independently pushing their music, and that's where I'm at. That's the lane I'm at. Independence to me is more independent and thought free zone, you know.
I forbid it. I'm feeling more than apples rotting in my orchard. Broke planets around my orbit. Asking Christ questions, that's rhetoric. My life feels metamorphic. And sorry if I'm going over your head, but being broke messes with your head like Sudafed.
You freely think and you freely develop in an audience. And that's what music is. Music is beautiful. I mean, music makes the world run. If we didn't have music, we didn't have entertainment, it wouldn't be anything.
What up, niggas? Check it out. This is the C4J record. This is DDS. The same set of covers. Hot, right? And this guy's side. And this is a photographer. Courtney Hurley. So, you know.
We took the pictures in a car. It was his vision. Voice in the wilderness.
Yeah, she kind of tweaked the background. You know, I was against the tree in turn. And then I wanted to give y'all half of me, so on the back, y'all can see the Timberland boots and all the other kind of stuff. You know, just to see the grime, the grim of it, you know. But then now we're looking at the DVD cover, because more so than ever, we're showing the documentary cover. It's background. I want me facing myself. But this is the mural on the wall, like it's almost like a poster, kind of like I'm in like the project or something, and I'm looking up and it's like a picture, already like a picture right there. So it's kind of like me looking over.
You want me to cut that picture? You want to put it
behind it? Yeah, like this, like the background, like that background on the wall. But I mean, of course, minimize me or something, and then like the background, me, just my picture, like this. This is the wall. This is the wall, and then I'm facing.
You want this on top of that?
Yeah, in front of that.
Right there?
Yeah, like right there, and so you can still see my face, but you can see DDS. You put any like up here, right? St. Joe's documentary. Then on the back of it, just put C4J, you know, www.
That's a color picture.
I know it's gonna be hot.
One thing I can say about DDS's artistic abilities is he's very creative and he's unique.
I made my first demo tape when I was 18 years old. I was nervous as hell, hoping I ain't fail. A lot of brothers on the block sold. I didn't want to sell, but I didn't want to fail. I wanted to excel. I used to write my lyrics.
So you talked about the market being saturated, you know, all these artists out today. What makes you different from what you hear today?
What makes me different is the simple fact, of course, there's a lot of artists now in hip-hop that produce and rap, and I give props and kudos to, you know, people like J. Cole, Big Crit, you know, who are doing that. Like, it's other people, many other people out there doing it, you know. But what makes me different, besides the fact that I do produce, I produce original music, you know. I play it, you know. I mean, hip hop is a fusion of course, people, you know, niggas always sample records and do this and that. You know, that's cool. I like to listen to records for inspiration, but I don't sample them. What makes me different, I'm an entertainer, an ultimate entertainer. You know, I started on a website called Artist DDS, which kind of was a platform. A lot of artists use YouTube or, you know, a lot of other stuff to get a platform for artists to, you know, or audiences to come and see them. And ain't nothing wrong with that. That's all love. But I just decided to just kind of like branch out and create artistdds.com, which is. Artist freedom is unlimited expression. When you are an artist, your art should be, you should be able to express yourself in a free zone.
The whole day flashes between my eyes, it goes on in my head very quickly. Think about who I need to talk to, who I need to meet with. I mean, I'm from Milwaukee, man. But every time I think about it, I do it all for the love of music, baby. When I pop in a brand new disc, it slows my whole day down. Keep doing it for the love, man. Keep doing it for the love.
You know what I mean? Freely. I like to express my art. So my plateau is different. I act. I do comedic stuff. You know, I do comedy sketches, reality TV. You know, and what makes me different is the simple fact of that I don't try to, that I've actually been doing it all my life. I was in acting school, you know. I was in, I'm an audio engineer, and I also was a film person. I was a recording student and a film person. So I always did film and I always did music.
Let me do it, man. I'm sorry, man.
Bobby, last time I told you to stop hating, Bobby. Now you've been stealing from the family business, Bobby.
I'm sorry, man.
Put your balls in the door, Bobby. Slam the door, Bobby.
Oh, oh my balls, man.
Slam the door, Bobby. Job well done.
Music was always in the forefront in film, and is what helped me express. Nowadays, you need visuals, so it's kind of like if you don't have a visual, you know, people can probably sometimes get just a song and listen to it, but once you add the visuals to it, you know, it helps that song even better. So that's what makes me different, is I'm a full, all outright entertainer that is not, you know, perpetrating the culture, but I'm part of it, you know. I've done it professionally, I do it professionally, and I just do it because I love it.
Because last night one of my niggas was handcuffed under arrest. The land is rough, no one to caress. Grip my wife, dunk, put my head onto her breast. Make love, but more kids come.
So I'm thinking about on Pandora Radio, right? If you were to select an artist, or where they say your particular music has to play on a type of artist or artist station, or if you are the artist themselves, what other artist would be associated with your music, your sound?
My sound is unique, you know. So my sound is a blend of, you know, acoustics and piano and bass and, you know, just playing around with music. My music could be, you know, put in, my sound could be, you know, caught in, if you're listening to jazz, or you could be caught if you're listening to a little, you know, alternative or hip hop. But my, far as my style, it is so ironic of my style being kind of like similar to like the Wu-Tang Clan in a sense, because my music is, I use my knowledge to, like they do, you know, to cut down other artists, you know. Some people use, you know, money and just flashing around and bravado and all that other stuff. I use wisdom, you know.
I thank God that you're not lost. Put them up. I live for you. I die for you. I'm free for you. I strive for you. And yo, I'm here to help you carry your cross. Give you some direction. Apparently you lost.
Free love. Freedom. Freeze, thumbs up, cause I see one love, and what's amongst us is the sum of barriers that need to be broken down so we can come up. Some search for silver and gold, the rivers that froze, only because the waters mirror they sow.
My tongue is very sharp, so that's that comparison there. And it's funny because I grew up not liking Wu-Tang as much, because my best friend used to play it all the time, and I was just kind of like, I wasn't dissing them, I just wasn't really trying to, I wasn't really listening to them. I was just like, ah, whatever. But as I got older, you know, I studied, you know, got all the albums and, you know, this and that, I found myself very similar, you know. They fuse and blend their beliefs and their 5% beliefs. And I being raised up around the block where it's a church house and a liquor store. My dad is a pastor, you know, so a lot of stuff growing up, my dad wasn't always a pastor, but I grew up in that church atmosphere, and I also grew up in that block atmosphere. So fusing my beliefs kind of the way they do it with reality, you know, and it's not gospel at all. My music is in my own lane, and I don't preach. I don't preach. I say like KRS-One, I kind of teach and, you know, lead niggas to the promised land, you know, that it's real gutter, like almost like Scarface as well. And that's my style of music.
So as far as the decline in rap music, I think that that's true. I think that rap has lost some of its relevancy, especially among young listeners. I think they want something more socially impactful, and I think that Derek DDS has something to say and will give a new voice to the whole rap.
Last question. So, three things DDS absolutely cannot live without.
I can't live without music. I can't live without, well, first and foremost, I can't live without, you know, my relationship with Jesus. That's my best friend. Secondly, I can't live without, you know, my family. And I definitely can't live without music. I can't. Music is my everyday. It's what I do. I wake up, it's like wake and bake, you know what I mean? I wake up and get high off my music, and those are three things. You take those from me, there's no DDS at all.